as a little kid going here, some days we'd come to school and we'd have a sore throat or we didn't feel well. And the teacher'd send us over to Dr. Thomas if she thought it was a real thing. And, you know, we never had to pay him. I don't know who paid him, if anybody paid him. None of the kids paid.
Dr. Robert F. Thomas was a young missionary, minister, and medical doctor who came to the shut-in mountain people and saved many lives, both physically and spiritually.
I heard about the community where I settled and where I spent many happy years serving as a mountain physician, Pittman Community Center in Sevier County, near what is now the Great Smoky Mountains National Park.
He was one of these doctors, if somebody called him, he'd go.
Following the Civil War, with their economies devastated, southern states had little money to spend on education and health care. Religious organizations stepped in to fill the need. During the missions movement of the early 20th century, reformers arrived to establish schools, churches, and clinics in rural areas.
Dr. Thomas had been a missionary minister in Malaysia, and he realized that they needed medical attention as well as spiritual. So he came back to get his medical degree. He that heard about the need with locked communities or locked-in communities where people could not get a proper education due to the fact of poor roads and facilities.
That he came here around 1926 and he was going to stay 1 year. And when he got here, he saw how bad these mountain people needed him. And he ended up spending his life here.
He was here through the Depression. He was here through the founding of the park. He saw all the transition from the time that he would have been on horseback and to modern roads, from kerosene lamps to electricity, from peace through World War II and on again.
People would barter and offer him whatever they had. I mean, it was a matter of give and take. A farmer might have a lot of produce or garden materials or things that they had raised on their land, and they could exchange that for Dr. Thomas's services.
And I remember Dr. Thomas. He was a doctor, and once in a while when you had an earache or something, you didn't feel well, you had to go over there.
His most famous patient would have been Avalee Parton. And that's when he went down the road one snowy day. It was in January the 19th, 1946. And Avalee Parton was having her fourth child, which was Dolly Parton.
The night that I was born, my mother was in labor for, I guess, 15, 17 hours. And the snow was so deep, so my dad rode out on horseback to get Dr. Thomas to ride back in on horseback. But I always said Daddy couldn't pay him. I was paid for with a sack of cornmeal. That's where the joke came from, that I've been rolling in the dough ever since.
With his background and training, he filled many posts, many shoes, and he was a minister as well as a physician.
As the rest of the country reeled from the Great Depression in the 1930s, the mountain people, with their barter economy, were far removed from the financial consequences of the stock market.
Well, certainly the things that were going on in our lives were the same thing was going on in all the people around our parts of the country. No matter what was going on in the world or around the United States, in our part of the world, people were still having hard times, as they still do.
He'd ride a horse where he could, but if he couldn't, he'd walk. he'd go see him. Spend his life here looking after mountain people.
Many mountain people were direct descendants of families who received land grants following the Revolutionary War. Shielded by the mountains, their ways had remained unchanged for nearly 150 years.
He was always being called up to these homes where a lot of these people were just really backwoods, redneck people, where people would actually hold a gun on him to say, if you let my wife die or if you let my kid die, I'm going to kill you, that sort of thing.
Well, he was never private about his spirituality. He wanted to bring as many people as he could to Christ. That was his whole mission in life, really. And he said, I can't bring them to the Lord if they're too sick to understand me.
According to his journals and missionary records, in an average year, Dr. Thomas would travel more than 15,000 miles, make more than 1,000 house calls, and make his calls primarily on foot or on horseback. Following World War II, Pittman Center became a model for rural medicine. For example, in 1948 alone, nearly 200 visitors from half the United States and many countries came to see the center.
Dr. Thomas really became a model for many others in rural areas.
As the 20th century moved more and more into the modern age, many doctors were lured away from small communities into larger cities. Other doctors, teachers, and missionaries cycled through the Appalachian settlements, but Dr. Thomas stayed committed to the mountain people of Sevier County.
He took care of the soul and the mind and the body, and God really gave him an angel's heart. And God does put some of those people in our paths, and in the Smoky Mountains, the people felt like that God had sent him to us.
And if it hadn't come to these mountains, I don't know where any of us would be today. I'm just so thankful. I thank God for sending this man.
He left a great legacy of service, of caring for people, and I think that's lasted.
So many people in our area were not educated, couldn't read and write, and couldn't even read what was on the newspaper. So he was actually, in every way, our connection to the bigger world and also that center in the small world that we lived in.
Providence is the hand of God in the glove of history. The glove will never move until the hand moves. Until God moves, the glove laid still. And Dr. Thomas answered the call and came forth. That's what I call providence. The hand of God moved in the glove of history.
Robert's interest as a boy was to be a doctor or a preacher. His mother said, I just want you to be a good man. In his lifetime, he accomplished all three when he came to the Great Smoky Mountains as the horseback healer of body and soul.
Even if they didn't have money. Now, often I've heard they saying, well, I sure hate it, Doc, that I ain't got no money to pay you with now. But if you don't get paid in this life, you'll sure get paid in heaven.